Hey friends, welcome back. I don't know about you, but I'm ready for this quarantine to be over. The first place that I plan to go after the quarantine is lifted is to get my eyebrows threaded. They are being so uncooperative. So while you're here, make sure that you're hitting that subscribe button and use the notification bell next to the subscription button so you can be notified every time I post new content. Today I am going to do a winged liner tutorial by request, and let's jump right in. For the winged liner, typically I use a liquid liner. These are the different ones that I have here. We have the infamous tattoo liner by Kat Von D and Trooper Black, which is usually what I use. We have the TARDIS double-ended. It has a felt tip as well as the regular pencil tip. We have Sex Kitten by Tarte with the little cat on the end here. We have also a long pointy felt tip. We have Sugar Wingman waterproof liner. Felt tip. And then the dagger liner, tattoo liner by Kat Von D as well, also in Trooper Black. The dagger is, I'm not sure if you can see that, slanted on the end. The Kat Von D liners are kind of like a brush tip, if that makes sense. Not necessarily a felt tip where there are multiple. Let me see if I can show you. I'm not sure if you can see, but it is brush tip. So I'm gonna try out the Sex Kitten liner. I have used this once or twice, I believe. So I'm gonna start on the corner of my eye. I'm gonna draw my line. It's probably about as long as I want it to go. I'm gonna start on the inner corner of my eye, and I'm just gonna lay it on my lash line. And just drag it. Once I get over toward the end, I'm gonna put my liner at a little bit of an angle instead of flat. And I'm gonna connect it with the tip. And as you can see, this doesn't look very natural. So I'm gonna thicken it up a bit. And then I'm just going to fill in the negative space. So that doesn't look as sharp as I would like it to. I think mostly due to the way the tip is here. So you can take a Q-tip and clean up the edge. If you're happy with that, you can leave it as it is, or you can go back in and sharpen that line up a little bit more. It's up to you. I'm gonna attempt to do that. Usually when I keep messing with my liner, it ends up being really thick and Amy Winehousey. I think I'm not a big fan, not a super fan of this Sex Kitten liner. Let's try the Wingman waterproof liner by Sugar. Now on your opposite eye, I'm gonna draw my line, and then I'm gonna start at the corner here and draw it down. It's easier for me because I'm right-handed. If you're left-handed, I'm not sure. I'm not really sure how you would do it if you're left-handed, because I'm not. It would probably be the opposite for someone who's left-handed. Now, say you mess up toward the corner. You can do the same thing by taking a Q-tip, fixing the line, or you can completely wipe it off and finish it out. I don't typically do liner without like eyeshadow or things like that, so this looks a little weird to me. Not sure if this is what you're looking for, Pearl. I think one of the biggest things with liner is that you want to make sure that you keep the liquid liner flow to the tip, because when it's dry, it kind of will skip and drag. There you have it. Use two different ones on each eye. There's a lot of tips and tricks that people use to get the line straight and their wing straight. They actually sell eyeliner that has the stamp on it that you put it on and drag it across. I haven't personally tried that one. I am thinking about getting it just so I can do a does this thing work segment on that product, as well as some other ones. People also use, not the bumpy side, people also use things like bobby pins and things like that to draw their line with. I don't do that just because I have success doing my wing on my own most of the time. So if you have any tips on this that you would like me to put in the next video, let me know. If you have any questions, drop it in the comments. And make sure you drop where you're planning to go first after the quarantine in the comments as well, so I can see what everyone's planning on doing once it's lifted. Please like, share, comment, subscribe, invite your friends and family to watch my videos. Let me know if you have any suggestions for future videos. And thanks so much for watching.